So, good morning and good evening, friends. Welcome to the session of jQuery part 2. So, quickly I will cover up what we discussed initially. So, we discussed that jQuery is a library, JavaScript library, which gives us a platform over the browser, okay, to talk with the browser basic functionality in a very uniform manner, so that you can write a common method to every browser and it will work in all browsers. Suppose you have a command to select something and you can write your CSS3 selector or whatever HTML, so it will select that element regardless of the browser you have selected. Suppose you have Mozilla or whatever, this will come. Okay. This will work. And we have we went through all the traversals, like we can traverse to the children, parent, we can select a parent of a node, we can find or we can filter. Okay, all those things we discussed, how we will filter up a particular element. Suppose there are 10 elements, out of them I want to select only the drop down list, then I can select with the filter command only the drop downs. So I showed you some demos also, and then we went through the manipulation as well, how to manipulate their HTML, how to append element to particular target. Suppose you have a div and you want to append some new div inside that div, how can you append dynamically from JavaScript using this jQuery command, and how you do wrapping. Suppose you have multiple contents and you want to wrap them dynamically in a div, so how you will do it dynamically using jQuery. Similarly, we discussed about this all selectors, some more selectors, like how to select using the ID, how to select using the attributes, how to select using their property, if there are hidden fields are there and you want to select all the hidden elements, then directly you can type this command and it will select all the hiddens, and then you can filter out, okay, from the hiddens you want only the drop downs which are hidden, like that you can filter out also. So, and now
so wherever I have to use jQuery in PBG, is it I have to use with so many combination, or is there any specific condition where I have to use the jQuery?
No, there is not such conditions actually. So the question was where I should use jQuery. So jQuery is something which is more of a web application. Suppose you are using web application and there you have to use your JavaScript to do some client-side some work. So writing JavaScript, you can, instead of writing JavaScript, core JavaScript, you can write your jQuery command instead of that. So whatever manipulation, traversal you do using your JavaScript, you can do using your jQuery. Suppose you do get element by ID and then you replace its value. Okay, the same thing you can do using jQuery, and then you can manipulate the value also.
Same thing I can achieve through the jQuery also, and even also with JavaScript.
JavaScript. The difference is that if you use JavaScript, then you have to take care of IE, Mozilla and all the browsers, because JavaScript will not work in all browsers similarly, because every browser will have their own DOM reaction. Suppose their DOM will behave differently with the same command of the JavaScript. So in the jQuery, they have handled all these kinds of things. Suppose you want to add the events, then these things can be taken care. So we discussed about these things. So now we'll discuss about the attributes. So before I will go to the attributes, do we have any questions in phone? Okay. So we'll go to the attribute section. So attribute is something that you want to change some behavior of the elements. Okay, it is not as much as good as behavior. It's something which is called as a look and feel and all those and some attributes. Let's say if you have a div element and you want to change it some attribute, let's say some style attribute, you want to change width, you want to change height, you want to change the class element itself. So you can very easily use this commands, attribute command, attr attribute command. So in this attribute, you can pass your name value pair, okay, the name and the value. Name will be, let's say you want to change the width or you want to change the title. Suppose there is an input and you want to change the title, then you will pass title and whatever value you will give it, it will come in the tooltip. Similarly, name and function also. suppose you want to change the title based on some functionality, you can write your own function also. Okay, suppose you have some condition, if user is hovering then put this title, if user is moving out then put this title, and this method can be taken care by this function, and it will go in the title in the tooltip. Similarly, some properties you can find out the values also. Suppose you want to know what is the width of the particular element, then what you will do, you will just write in the property, you will write your width and it will give you the value.
So I have to take this the returns value into the any value.
Yeah, you can take anywhere. Yeah, equal to where, equal to something, and then you can write.
Okay.
Similarly, remove attribute is there. Dynamically, you can remove your attributes also. Suppose you have added some title or some fields or something, and now you don't want those things, then you can remove also. So if you write remove width, then it will remove entirely width property from that element.
Okay, means in within the JavaScript, I can write some conditional code, and into that I can use the directly this method.
This method.
Properties methods.
Correct. Similarly, CSS, suppose you have some CSS rules you want to apply, then you can apply a name value pair as well as properties. Properties is nothing but the object. You can pass the complete class object inside that, and you can pass very CSS rules. That's a width, height, and all those things you can collectively pass inside this object. And there is something good command that is called as add class command. Add class is very useful. At runtime, you can add some class. At runtime, you can remove some class also. So I will show you quickly I will go through the some few examples. So that will help us to actually visualize what we are talking. So let's say I have few couple of examples. I'll try to go through them as quickly. So see here, let's say the first example says, okay, this is my grid ID. I'm selecting my grid with giving the ID, and I'm giving CSS as a font size 18 pixels. So I'm changing its CSS property with the font size. So the moment I will execute this command, it will change my font size to 18 quickly. Okay, and if you see, similarly, if you see second, what I'm doing here, I'm selecting the first row of a grid and I'm changing its background to green and font color to orange. The moment I will do like this, it will change its first rows background color and font color very quickly. So it's just a CSS property I am adding. And see here, I am giving an object, I am passing one object having two different properties. Similarly, if you see here, it is same, this one is CSS property, I am giving the same red. Okay, and suppose this command, what I am doing here, and I'm finding not first, last, and all the event. Means I want to change the color, background color of all the event rows.
Even rows.
Okay, so what I'm doing here, tr not first and last, and select only event. Okay, and change the background color to red. Okay, and add the black theme class. See, add class I'm using, but dynamically I'm adding the one class also to change the color of the rows.
So this class black theme.
Yeah.
Black theme, it is in your CSS.
Yes, black theme is in CSS. So the moment I apply black theme, it will do all, it will put all them in a black color. Okay, if I would run this only, then what it will do, it will change the background color of the event rows only. Let me refresh this. I've done many manipulations, so it is over already. Okay, so what I was saying is that, suppose I will run this command only, so it will change the background color of the event rows. Okay, and how to add a class? Suppose I want to add one class black theme, which will change the background color to black and font color to white. It will do that. I showed you. Just suppose I want to remove also. Let's say let me apply a black theme class. See, black theme class I have applied now, and now I want to remove them dynamically also. So the moment I will do like this, it will go. Similarly, cursor, as I said, hand, if I put, suppose there is a grid, I want to select the first column, and I want to change my title as a my name, and CSS cursor, I am applying hand. So see, I am putting two different things. First I am applying attribute, and then I am applying CSS property as well. Because each time you do some manipulation, it will return you the same object. jQuery will return you the same object. so that you can again do manipulation on that.
Okay, means you can, I can every time.
Yeah, suppose this
combine the all methods into the, and apply to the single.
Single it's
command.
A kind of chaining. Suppose if I'll apply this, then it will change the first one. If you select, see, this is title is coming my name, tooltip, and it is something cursor. Cursor is something coming hand. See, everywhere it is not hand, but here I changed. Similarly, you can do many manipulation, like has, suppose you can check also has class, if this grid has a black theme class or not. So has class is very useful to check dynamically, okay, what class does this div or does this element have. Suppose if I will apply, I have not applied black theme class, and if I will say execute this, it will return false. If you write here alert, then it should return. Suppose if you write here alert, then it should return you false. See, false. So if you apply black theme, then it will return you true. Okay. So let me go to the presentation, because we have to move fast little bit today. So these are all attributes. So do you have any question in phone? Okay. So let's go to the some few more, as we said, HTML, text, well, these are all setting and getting properties. You can set the property using text, using HTML. If you use HTML, then it will change the HTML also.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and text, if you change, if you write something on the text, then it will come as a text. If you write something on the well, then it will change the value of that particular input. Suppose you have a text box and you want to change the text box value. You have a drop down, you want to change the drop down value. Then you can use directly this well.
We can pass the object.
Object also.
Object.
Okay, so you will select some input and you will change the value of that input. Similarly, attribute, as we discussed, CSS, these are all getting properties. You can get the CSS property as well. Suppose there is a div element and you want to width, you want the width CSS. What is the value of the width? What is the value of the background color? So if you put background color, it will return you the value of the background color. Similarly, height, it will directly give you the height. This is a function. If you apply on a any jQuery object, then it will return you the height of that particular object. Width is something which is again a Boolean expression. Okay, is, and you can write your expression here. Suppose you want, okay, you want all the td, then you can write dot is, and then you can write td. So it will give you the td only. It will check whether it is td or not. Okay, so it will return you blue Boolean value, true or false. Similarly, has class, as I discussed, it will return you true or false. Offset is, it is something that it will give you the offset value. Offset left, offset top. Suppose there is a div and you want to know the what is the its left value, what is its top, top value. So you can write offset function and then dot left dot top, it will give you the value. I'll show you a few examples again quickly. So these are all these things, HTML, text, we discussed now. So I think I have showed you everything on that. Similarly, chaining, as I was saying you that jQuery is something that if you, it allows you to do more manipulation on a particular selected object. So it, what it does is that suppose you have written some command, some manipulation command, then jQuery will return you the same set of object again to you. Okay, and having done the same manipulation on that object, it will return you the same set of objects so that you can do your own again. You can write some more manipulation, so it's more faster and it is more easier also, right? So you don't have to select again and again. You have selected once and now you want to do multiple actions, so you can do one by one actions. Similarly, say, let's say you have selected some element and you want to do action 1 and action 2 like this. So you can do that multiple actions.
I can apply multiple methods in a single command.
In a single selected object.
Single.
So how to respond to the user? So now we'll go to the bindings, and these are very important things. See, actually if you go through the bindings, then you know that there are click events, mouse over events, mouse out events. These are all events we know, right?
Yeah.
But the behavior of those events are different. In I6, you have to add it in a different way, okay, click event. In I7, you have to take care of in a different way. In a Mozilla, you have to add it in a different way. But if you use jQuery, and again, you know that if you want to add the click event, then you have to write on click. You have to write on mouse over. So those are not standard events. Okay, you have to write on like this. But if you use jQuery, then they will allow you to write the standard events name directly.
Directly
you can right click, directly you can write mouse over, and if you right click, then it will take care of all the browsers that it will work. Okay, so it will take care of all the bubble raising events,
mm-hmm.
all those things it will take care. So you can use click, mouse over, mouse out, mouse enter. I'll list down few of the events. There are many events actually. We can go through the website and we can see. Mouse leave is something that you're leaving from an area, from
mm-hmm.
a selected area. Blur.
Mm-hmm.
Change, double click, focus, key down, key up, key press, scroll, resize, load, ready.
All
what is load? Load is something that we use normally.
Mm-hmm.
After the page load or the mm-hmm. particular div you want to something to be loaded and then. And this ready is what? It is the important one. This is created by jQuery actually. Means they have started using this ready and it is very useful also. Ready is something that your DOM is ready to do manipulation. Okay. What we do generally, we normally, suppose we want to add a click event or something, then what we do generally? We used to write in a page load command. Page load event.
Mm-hmm.
What we do in the page load? We add some click event or something. So in the page load, what happens is that it is very late. Page load trigger event will fire after the DOM is completely rendered in the browser and
mm-hmm.
all the CSS files, all the JavaScripts have been downloaded. After that, it will fire the page load. Okay, but before that also you can do your manipulation. That is called as ready event. That is document is ready to do manipulation.
But not rendered yet.
But not rendered. So if you write at that time some events, then it will be very very faster to you and you should not wait. What happens sometimes? What happens? Some text box is already rendered, okay?
Rendered.
And you have written on blur command something on that. Suppose, and in page load. User, what user will do? User will go and write something on that. But
okay.
You have written blur command that has not executed yet. The moment it will render, it will execute. The user will feel like, okay, I was writing and it went somewhere. After the complete rendering, your cursor will went somewhere else. And you have written some few of the commands, few of the text inside that. It happens. It normally happens. So that is because of this only, because they have written their scripts after page load, it is rendering, it is executing. And user was writing its text, okay, because he is seeing very before. Okay. So if he would have written this blur command in the ready event, then the moment the text is rendered, you can type everything and you can do everything. The cursor will automatically go to the somewhere else before
then
rendering.
Will reload it.
Before rendering. Yes. So ready is that. So some click events or some events, I will show you how to bind the events. Suppose I will show you click event, how to bind the click event. Okay. Let me refresh my browser. So let's say I show you how to bind the click event. So suppose there is I'm selecting second column. Okay, second column I'm selecting td nth child 2. Nth child 2 means I'm selecting the second column and I'm binding the click event on top of that. So dot click and I'm writing my function inside the click event. I want to do something. Okay. And if inside the click event you can write your this will nothing but a
grid.
Not grid, it will be your cell, the particular selected cell. Okay, you have selected column number 2 means 1, 2. You have selected town column and the all of them is the this means what? This first row, second row, third column, fourth cell, fifth cell, these are all this. So it will execute one by one in all of them. Okay, this means this particular cell, particular one cell, and you are applying on that some CSS background pink color you are applying. Okay, and again after writing your click event, suppose if I will execute this much only, okay, suppose I have executed this, see the second column is been selected and click event is applied. The moment I will click, it will change the background color to pink. So this means what? One of each of the cell, this means. So if I'll click here, it will change color. If I'll click here, it will change color. If you click here, it will change color. So all the cells which are selected, okay, those have been applied click events.
But why it get to first vertical line get pink? I'm not getting it.
which line
means
is pink?
First time you executed it.
Okay. This is because of my, I am putting some classes, okay, to show you which are the columns selected.
Okay.
So this is my...
You just highlighted it.
Highlighted
it.
Okay. So this is something different. So suppose, and now I want to add mouse leave event on top of that. Okay. So let's say, I want to add mouse leave event again. So I will run this command. Okay. So what mouse leave will do, the moment I leave my mouse, it will change the color to yellow. Okay, let me execute this. So the moment I am leaving, see this is changing my color to yellow. See, I come here, I leave here. It is changing the color. Similarly, mouse enter, I want to change it to aqua color. So I will run all the commands together. Now see, I am entering, it is changing color, leaving changing color, okay, clicking, it will changing color. So all the events together I can write multiple events also in a same cell. This is also possible in jQuery.
Okay, but in that case, first time in a you have to the in the body you have to given the which nth click child to.
Yes.
Is it first time you have to give it?
Yes.
And again for the consecutive way you have to just connect the all events to that specific to the that child node.
Yes.
Is it correct?
Yes.
Like if I have to do it for the row,
mm-hmm.
then what I have to make the change?
Yeah, you have to do
for the specific row.
Yeah, then tr first you can select tr first. If you want to do for only first row or tr only, then you have to change this selection command. You can write here tr first, so it will change the first row only.
Okay.
Similarly, second or third or anything you want to select, you can select.
Okay.
Using your selector. Okay. So let's show some tooltip. I will show you quickly one more demo, so that just idea for the idea, because we use tooltips. So I'll show you, I'll not take more time. So you have to cover half an hour, we have already covered. So this is something query which is changing the first cell, which contains Rupesh. So in the table, there is only one cell which is containing Rupesh. So I'm changing that cell to do something different. If I will hover on that, okay, what I am doing, on click of that I am showing some tooltip. Dynamically I am generating one div, okay, and I am changing the background color and all. The moment I will execute this, okay, I will select this. There is some issue.
No, you have not selected complete this.
Okay, so now if I click here, then it will show you some tooltip. On tooltip it will show you the text of that cell. Okay, similarly second time, third time, many times I will do. So this is just an idea. You can do like this many things. On hover you can generate tooltip runtimely, so you don't need to put div in the page. And you have to, because if you put div in the page, then it will increase the page size. You don't want to put the div, so those things you can do very quickly. So any questions, anything now on phone, any question?
No.
Okay, so as I discussed that functions you can write also. So see here, there are you have selected something and now you have put some functions, and this is what function, these are all effects. Suppose you want to do hide, show, this kind of effects you can use. Show means something, it will show you the hidden things. Suppose you have hided your div and you want to show them again. So you can directly write show, it will do display block, or display none is hide. If you do hide, then it will hide the things. Toggle is something which will change the behavior. Okay, it will store the previous behavior. If it is already hidden, then it will become show. If it was already shown, then it will become hidden. So it will store toggle automatically. Correct. So you don't need to remember what is the state. You can directly write toggle, it will take care. Slide up is something like this.
Means
slide up, slide down.
In toggle, can we have to give the timeline also? Means
yeah, you can put your timelines also so that it will slowly or fastly. Similarly, slide up, slide down is something like this. And slide toggle, it will automatically take care like this, up and down. And fade in, fade out, it's fade in something like this. It will fade in like this. And fade out is something like this. So fade to is something you want to fade in particular, up to particular color, up to particular range. Suppose you want to fade to 0.3, so it will fade up to 0.3 only. And scroll, it will same. Suppose you want to unload, you want to scroll your page, okay, to particular extent. So you can scroll also. Suppose restoring the scroll positions on every page load, you want to restore the scroll position, you can use resize is same, page resize, load is same, ready as I discussed, ready. So I'll show you few effects actually which I have here in my demo, and then we will go to animation and then Ajax. So let me refresh this page. So these are we have already used, I think, because jQuery is very much famous because of its effects only. So normally people go to jQuery because of their effects. I want to hide some dynamically, some animation chahiye, we want some animation, so we generally use. So I think people know this. So what I'm doing here, I'm selecting the cells, okay, which has not the rupees text, and I'm hiding them. See, all the cells been hided, okay, except the row which is having rupees. Okay, similarly fade them. Let's say I want to fade some of them. And see here, I'm doing fade 2. Fade 2 is something, it will fade up to 0.5 and it will do it very fastly. So you can write like this, you can pass your parameters as well. Fast, slow, like this. See the TD which contains rupees, it is being faded. So see, it is faded out and it is now like something, it is disabled or something, it is looking something like that. Similarly, I want to do mouse over and I want to fade out them. Okay, all of the TD, I want to fade out them whenever I will do mouse over. Mouse over is something, if I will go and hover them. See, the moment I will hover, it will fade out. Fade out means it will hide. It's just like a game. If I will select and go, it will be hidden. Just like a game, you can do your time pass also. Similarly, see, these are all you can hide like this. Okay, so we show fade out and slide up, slide down is something shutter up, shutter down kind of thing. If I do slide up, then it will hide the things, but it will go like this. It is very faster, so now it has not been shown. So if you write here slow, and slide down, it will come up, slide up. Similarly, slide toggle, it will do automatically, it will show you, it will hide you, hide it. So it will automatically take care. And toggle is something same. See, toggle is something fade out, fade in. Okay, fade out is something that it will hide it in a very smooth way. Okay, so let's go to the animation. If you need little bit more from jQuery, then this is the thing, animation. So animation is very useful actually, advanced animation. So this has been used in game kind of application. Suppose you are creating game application and something, and you want to do animation, or then you can use it. So animation is something that you can animate your element by your own style. You can pass your own parameters up to which time you want to animate them, and easing also you want to go them in sliding way or toggling way, or you want to go them swingly like this, you can put easing. And callbacks is like after doing animation what you want to do, that is callback. So all the parameters I have explained. So suppose I want to show it quickly, I will show you one demo. So I'll show you one demo how to do animation. Let me refresh my this. So what I want to do here, okay, I'm selecting first cell again. First cell is again the cell which is containing rupees. And what I'm doing here, I'm passing the first parameter as my animation. What I want to do is that animation is what I'm passing on object. Okay, I'm changing the CSS color and I'm passing the object position absolute top. Okay, top, and then I am doing TD first and offset top left and offset like this. So what I am doing here, this one is my first object up to here. Okay, this is the selection, and then I am putting animate. Okay, first I am changing the things, some properties. I am applying some properties on my first cell. What are the properties I am applying? Position absolute and top. I am putting top value something. and left value something, okay, and then I am applying animate. In animation, I am first parameter is my parameter top, where I want to put them, top left, where I want to put them, and 4000 in the duration, 4 seconds, up to 4 seconds, and it will go linearly, and after doing that it will say done. So if I'll execute it, see the first row is going like this, and if you go, it will say you done. So what happened, it went to 00 position. See, my first I have given up to 00, it will go. The moment I will say, let's say it, I want to send them 45 and 211, so it will again move from there. See, it is moving. So like this you can pass, and if you want to them very quickly, then you can put 1 second also. Now I have put 4 second. So if you will say, change it to again, let's say 0, left 0, and go it 1 second, within 1 second. So it will go within 1 second. Okay, the position I have not changed much. So it will go within 1 second. So this is the animation, that thing you can use. So yeah, it has already taken out that first cell from the grid and it has moved to somewhere else. So this is just the idea. You can do many more things there. So any questions? Okay, so the most awaited thing is the Ajax. So because of this Ajax only, jQuery is much more famous. Because using this Ajax, they have many handy-dandy functions like load, get. Okay, by using them, you can directly run your server-side command using your jQuery Ajax command. Okay, and these are very much using now. These are very much useful in MVC pattern. So in MVC pattern, we are using jQuery extensively. We are using jQuery, and we are using those commands like load. What is load? Load is something that it will load some div or some HTML element. Any HTML it will load inside a div or inside a selected element. Suppose you have selected a div and you want to load your different page at all. Suppose in the URL you can pass your page, and in the data you can pass some data to that page so that it will do some manipulation. And after loading, what you want to do is you can put in callback. Okay, so similarly post is something you want to post something. Suppose on click a button and you want to post some data to the server side. So you don't need to post the entire page, you can just post some data. Whatever data you want to post, you can put in the data is object, and you can post some data to that URL, and in the callback it will return you the, from the server, if you want to return something, then in the callback you will get the thing. And similarly get is something you want to do some get operation. Okay, you want to get something from the server side, then you can use the get operation. So in Ajax there are many options. Again, in Ajax you can pass your data, you can say your type, whether it is a post or get, you can pass your URL, which URL you want to do, and there are some events also. So I'll show you some of the Ajax start. Suppose you have your events also. So the moment you say Ajax start and you binded something, so suppose you are starting your Ajax operation and you want to show the continuing image or something, progressing image something, before starting your Ajax, then you can bind it like this. Whenever Ajax operation will start, it will execute this event first, and you can show your progressing image or something, and you can do any pre thing you want to do before doing your Ajax operation. Ajax send is something that just you have sent your request, and Ajax success means if your Ajax call has been successed and whatever server has replied, it came to you, then this will be executed. Ajax error is something, if there is some error, then this event will be executed. So you can bind your event handlers on each of them events. So similarly like this, you can write $ajax and event name, $ajax data type, okay, Ajax success error, all those events you can write here. Okay, similarly as I said before, send, success, error, complete is something that it will say after Ajax completed you want to hide your progress image. So those things you can do. So I'll show you some demo in Ajax. First I'll show you load. Okay, and then I'll show you some Ajax operation also. So load is something that I already said you, that load is something that it will load particular page to a div. Suppose I have a div, empty div. Okay, this is my div, which class I have applied a class empty on that, so I am selecting it using the class name empty, and I am loading one default.aspx page. Okay, this page is in my I have in my solution this page default.aspx page.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, in the same hierarchy I have this page, so this page I want to load inside this empty container. Okay, so I am using this command load. First parameter is my URL, second is my data, so I am not passing any data, so just empty object, and third is my after loading what I want to do, that is callback. So I can write my lambda expression here directly. This is nothing but a JavaScript lambda operation. So I am just writing one function, and inside that I am writing alert data.html page is loaded, something I want to show. Okay, so let me run this command. See, data.html page is loaded, and this page is being loaded on the
empty
div. Mm-hmm. And inside the page I have this 1, 2, 3, 4, I had some list, actually UL list I will show you. I had this in the page 1, 2, 3, 4, this is, so this page is completely been rendered in this. So see, in the same page, in my different page, I can load any page now very dynamically. Mm-hmm. And it's very very easy, and it's very much faster. Okay, you have loaded your page. Suppose you want to dynamically load a grid somewhere, then it is very much useful.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and again, suppose, and again it is,
mm-hmm,
it is something that you want to, you can select also some of them before loading. Suppose I want to load this page, and I can again write my expression, jQuery expression on top of that. I want to load only first li from the page. I want to load something. Suppose I have a big page,
mm-hmm,
and I want to load the big page, and on that page I want to show only grid. I don't want to show all of them. So what we do generally, we load the entire page and we hide some of them.
Mm-hmm.
So that is again a performance hit, because you are again loading entire thing. So instead of that, you can write before loading, you can write your expression. You can say, okay, from that page, give me that thing only. Suppose I want only first li, first list, then I can execute like this, and it will show you only first list. See, from that page, it has selected the first list, and it has loaded the same thing on your page.
So is it only work in static data, means you have the already static data, or it can
no.
be used in dynamic also?
Dynamically. The moment you will say load, your page load will go. If you put here debugger, then it will come here also. It will
okay.
go come in page load. You can do your binding database
yeah,
call
yeah.
and all those things
cool.
you can do.
Yeah, cool.
It will come here. So this is very much powerful actually, if you see.
Means it is same like our previously Ajax we have used.
Yes, good, it is same. And again, you can write your Ajax as well. So suppose you can also call your web services. I cannot go right now, if time will permit I will show you. Suppose you have a web service. See, this is my web service, get employee by name or something, and I want to get some employee. By passing name, I want the employee. Okay, and this is my class employee. So if I want to run this command, web service command from JavaScript, then also I can run it from here. Okay, I can write this command again, load, and in the URL I can pass my web service path, and in the callback I will get the data. Or you can use your direct $ajax command also, $ajax, and you can write entire thing here inside this. You can write URL. In the URL, you will write your web service path. This is my web service path, my service. So you can write here directly my service.asmx/ method name you have to write, get employee by name. Okay, and then similarly, second data you have to pass. What you are passing, some data, you have to pass name. So you can pass like this, name, colon, the value of the name. Okay, suppose you want to pass Rupesh. Similarly, like this you can pass, and in the success you can say something. And similarly in the error you can say something. So this is like this, you can call your Java web service from Ajax directly. JavaScript. From JavaScript you can call your web service, and web service will talk your database and will get you the result. So let's talk about the plugins. So if you think jQuery should do more, then this is for the discussion now. What jQuery should do more? We want some our functionality to come in the jQuery to come in the jQuery object. Let's say you have something and you want your own method, let's say binding of a drop down list. Okay, suppose you have a JSON data and you want to bind the drop down. So this is a very utility kind of method. You can use this method to everywhere. So you want that to put in your jQuery command itself. So now you want to put your own method in dollar, because dollar has some of the method, but some of the method it doesn't have. Let's say I'll show you how to extend jQuery. Mm-hmm. So jQuery has one function method, fn, jQuery.fn. And if you write jQuery.fn dot your method, then it will come in jQuery object inside. So jQuery.fn is nothing but a, so like this you can look, jQuery.fn dot my plugin, and you have to write your own plugin, what the plugin will do.
User-defined methods.
User-defined methods you can put inside that. And fn is nothing but a prototype. If you know prototype in JavaScript, then you should know that prototype is something that it is the base of the particular object. Mm-hmm. Okay, so it is adding in the prototype object so that it will be applied to all of the instance of the jQuery object. Okay, and the plugin has a magical plugin helper. It's come something each dot h. You have to use each. So suppose you are writing your plugin, then you have to write dollar this dot each, and then you have to write something inside that. Each means what? Because you have, whenever you will write your jQuery, then it will select multiple rows actually. Mm-hmm. Suppose you are selecting td, then it will select 10 tds if there are 10 tds. Then in each of the 10 tds you have to apply your whatever you are doing. So that's why you have to write each in your plugin. So the typical plugin should look like this. There should be, you have to write jQuery.fn, then your plugin name, and in the function you have to return. Why you have to write return? Because as I said you, jQuery what it does? It normally operates some operation on that selected elements, okay? And after that it returns the same object to you, so that you want to do any manipulation again, so you can do that. So you don't have to break that chain. You have to maintain that chain again. If you are writing your own method, then you have to maintain that chain. Okay. So you have to do your manipulation, whatever stuff you want to do, you do it. And after that, you have to return the same object set, so that you are maintaining the same chain. If you not
it's
do,
returning the
yeah.
Something.
If you will not do this, then jQuery will break. Means no, it will not break. It will not do.
Exhibit.
It will not allow you to do further manipulation.
Okay.
So if you are writing your own plugin, then you have to take care of these things. Okay. So let me show you quickly one plugin. It will help you to create your own plugins also. This is my plugin. I am writing dollar jQuery.function prototype, and on top of prototype I am adding one my plugin, and this is nothing equal to function, and inside the function what I am doing, return dollar this dot each. For each of them I am writing, changing the color, background color to green. Okay, let me execute this function. Okay, it has been executed. Now if I apply this, if I'll write this method, suppose I am selecting, let me select my table. Okay, I'm selecting the odd rows and I'm applying my own plugin which I just created. So see, my own plugin, what it did is that it changed the background color to green. So I have created my own method. So see, I have written my plugin and it did whatever it was supposed to do. So right, like this you can create your own methods on jQuery also. So any question? Okay, so okay, almost we have now completing entirely. So let me discuss some advanced jQuery. Okay, in advanced jQuery we should know what is stack. As I said you, stack is something that it is a kind of destructor. suppose you have selected some of the elements and you have done some manipulation on them, okay, and the moment you say end, then it goes to the previous okay element set. So this is come something like that. It is going to the previous and again previous, so it is maintaining all of them to in a stack, okay, so that you can go to the previous also. So that is been stored in a stack. So if I'll say you this, it is something like, suppose I have selected this tr or, okay, and did my manipulation, and I am saying dollar, and I am selecting all the td, let's say, and then I am again applying, let's say, css color blue. So what I am doing again I am selecting some all the TDs and I am changing their color to blue. Okay, sorry, I have to write add actually here, because I want to add some more expression. I want to add some more expression. I want to add all TDs to be blue. See, now everything is blue. Okay, all TDs are blue. If I will say dot end, then what will happen is that it will go to my previous set, all TR odds. See, first set was all TR odd, second set was all TDs. So if I will say dot end, then it will come to the first selector. The moment I'll say dot end, and then I will apply again, let's say CSS color red, then can anybody tell me what will happen? End dot CS, if I'll write this, can anyone tell me what will happen if I'll execute this?
It will end to the your first
selector.
First selector.
And then it will apply only. Yeah. So this red will go in the first one only.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and it's, let me refresh. CSS color red. Okay, actually it was not expected. It should go to the first and then it should change the color. Okay, plugin is gone. Sorry. The problem was that plugin is gone actually. So I should not use plugin, let me use it again CSS, because my plugin already gone, right? I have refreshed my page. So let's say again color aqua, okay, and if I will execute this, what happened now again? So idea is something like this, same, if tr odd and you again added some more selector and you say end, the moment you will say end, it will go to the again first selector. So what is that? All the selectors, jQuery stores them in a stack. So that I wanted to explain you actually. So a stack is something like this only. And advanced scripting is something that you can dynamically load your JavaScript and you can execute some of the commands from them. So this is, I think, none of the JavaScript libraries give this functionality actually. jQuery only gives this functionality. You can use directly dollar get script and you can pass the URL. URL is something that you want to load some JavaScript from a particular destination and you want to execute some of the method in from that. So dynamically, you don't need to write your whole JavaScript file in your page. Okay, suppose you have one JavaScript file and from that you want to use only one method, but that JavaScript is 300 KB size. Okay, so what you will do, you will first write the reference to your page. So while the page will rendering, it will load the whole JavaScript and you want to use only one. So it will take your time. So instead of that, what you can do, you can directly write the URL and you can use the one method from that. Directly it will allow you to use the one method. Similarly, get.json is very much handy. What it will do, suppose you want to get from the server some object, okay, some object from the server side, you want in a JavaScript. So you can use your get.json. Get.json will allow you to use the server side object in the JavaScript. So you can do any manipulation on that. So I think I've done. So so far, so is any questions from phone or here? Any questions?
No.
Okay. So these are my resources which I use, jQuery.com. Obviously, this one is the grand actually resource. Anyone can go to jQuery.com and you can see, because here you will see what are the new versions are coming. And one more thing I wanted to tell everybody is that we should use jQuery production version and dev version. There are two versions. So while you are developing your project, you should use dev version. And while deploying your project to the server side, you should use production version. What? Why? Because in production version, they do some they zip that file to somewhere, some extent that it reduces its size. Because when you write your JavaScript, you put enter, you put some spaces, okay. So it does some obfuscating on that, and it changes the files to a very it size reduces its size also. So that is called as zipping of your JZip kind of functionality you can use. So production version and dev version, all versions are there in that jQuery.com. You can download production version, dev version, and you can use that. So similarly, your own JavaScript also, you can do some zipping on that. You can remove all the spaces and all those things before deploying that. To do this kind of manipulation, there are some tools available in the website. You can use those tools. Now Visual Studio .NET 2010 is also giving some tools to zipping your JavaScript files. Also to zipping your CSS files also, there are some tools. So you can zip your CSS file, you can zip your JavaScript file before deploying to the production. And there is one more website, Visual jQuery. It is very useful. You can go to that website. It will allow you visually to see how jQuery runs. And book, this is jQuery in action, which I actually recommend to read everybody if you want to go more in jQuery. So jQuery in action is a good book actually. So thank you everybody for your patience and for being with me. And these are my contacts actually. If someone has any question, then always they can put them. Thank you everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you. Welcome. Okay, bye-bye.